नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज न्यूमेरिकल ऑन हेलिकल गियर, पार्ट ऑफ द हेलिकल गियर द लास्ट टॉपिक इज द दिस इज द न्यूमेरिकल व्हिच इज गिवन बेस्ड ऑन दैट वी हैव जनरेटेड द गिवन डाटा दैट इज पावर इज गिवन टू अस पिनियन स्पीड इज गिवन टू अस जेड पी जेड जी दैट इज नंबर ऑफ टीथ ऑन गियर एंड पिनियन इज गिवन टू अस ए इज गिवन टू अस एम एन इज गिवन टू अस अल्फा इज गिवन टू अस एस सी टी इज गिवन टू अस वी एच एन इज देयर एंड सर्विस फैक्टर इज देयर Okay, so now this helix angle. Before finding helix angle, we need to find out the torque cos. So torque can be found out with the help of this relation. We get the value of torque. This is the value of torque now. So to find out the helix angle, we need the center distance. A is equal to mn zg zp by 2 times cos of psi. So cos of psi, psi is here. You will get the value of psi that is 22.92 degree. This is the value of psi here. Okay, so this is how the helix angle is known to us. Now the beam strength. Beam strength is what? For that virtual number of teeth, for helical gear, the teeth is virtual number of teeth we have already seen. So ZP dash is ZP upon cos cube of psi. Based on that, we need to find out the value of y, that is the Lewis factor. For that, we did this interpolation method. Okay, so with the help of this interpolation method, that is the value of 40 and 45, these things are there. So value of 40 is 0.389 and 45 is 0.399. Between this you will find the value of 44.79, so it is 0.3985. before that we use this interpolation method which you have already learned in NACM also. So beam strength, to find out the beam strength, sigma b is needed, that is SC2 by 3. So put the value of sigma b, that is SC2, is equal to mn b sigma b y. Okay, and the value we get is, so here we get the second answer, that is beam strength. The same way wear strength. Wear strength q and k is needed. Q is equal to 2 times zg z upon zg plus zp. The same as the spur gear, so we get this k is same, dp is changed right now, zp mn upon cos of psi. Based on that, dp is 190 mm. So vs strength is what? Bq dpk by cos square of psi. Based on this we get 21495.69 newton. So static load is what? Pt is equal to 2 times torque upon dp. Okay, 2 times torque upon dp, so it is 2792.19. so this is how we get the static load. Now dynamic loading is what? For dynamic load formula we have, for that we need the diameter of gear also. Diameter of gear is what? Zg mn upon cos of psi. We get 380 mm. We need to find out the error also. Okay, because grid is given to us in the numerical. So based on that, this error is there, phi value is there. Put these values and we get error, we get the value of phi, that is 8.45, okay, and 9.87. so we get this value here, that is error on pinion and error on gear. It is 13.22 micrometer, 14.22 micrometer. Now total error is what? 27.44 micrometer. Based on this, we can find out the velocity, that is pi dpnp upon 10 to the power 3, 7.16 meter per second. Based on this, the service velocity factor is 0.673. put these values in the dynamic loading equation. This is the dynamic loading equation. Okay, we have psi, we have CEB. C is the deformation factor, that is been table taken from the table. E is here, B is the face width, static load we already have. Okay, now put all these values, we will get 8047 newton. This is the value of dynamic load. This is how it is being calculated. Okay,